So behold, the short stick. It's called a lot of different things. It can be called a stab, can be called a mill stick, can be called a tanbong. A lot of debate over the different Korean, Asian, Japanese, Okinawan names. Philippines call it something else. It's just a short stick, okay? It's not 6 feet tall, and it's bigger than an Eskrima stick, about twice as long. So whatever you choose to call it, let's learn how to use it. Well, obviously, it's a hiking stick and all the things that that implies, but we'll explore that in a separate video. As a weapon, think of it as a pool cue, okay? It's a blunt instrument, so obviously anything I club with it is going to get damaged. But the most effective way to use this is much like shooting a cue ball. If I wanted to thrust into you, I'm concentrating all the energy right into the tip, much like a bayoneted rifle. So let's just take a look at a couple of drills that you can use to improve your dexterity and learn how to use this weapon. And remember, these are just basic introduction ways to study different weapons before we jump into a little deeper discussion. No, you're not going to do this in combat. This is to teach your hands to have flexibility and dexterity. You're going to start with palms down and simply push your pinky down at the same time you open up your thumb and roll it around your hand. Let's do that a couple times. Yes, on TV and fictitious battles, you'll see the weapon flipping all over the place, behind the back, behind the head. All these are ways for you to have the weapon taken away from you. Okay, not the best way to do things. The best way to learn how to use this weapon is just to kind of think of it as about the same size as an M16 or a Kalashnikov, which is an AK-47. It's about the size of a rifle. Because it is about the same length of a rifle, think of it this way, you're going to hold it in rifle grip. Palm up, palm down, just like a rifle. Okay? And get past all the implications of that, okay? It's a stick. So relax. Okay? The best way to learn how to do this is to get in a good forward fighting stance, which is simply one leg forward, one leg back with about shoulder width. Kind of like you're in a football stance, ready to go. You should have about the same width as depth, as we've talked about in the Tong Sudo video. This gives you a solid basis to load. Basically, loading means take the point and shove it back as far as you can behind you, so that when you step forward with your right leg, you're going to thrust at the exact same time. Now, the point of this stick should hit the target the same time as your right foot plants, embedding all the energy, force, and weight and momentum that you've created by stepping forward. Arm strength is okay, right? But body strength is better. Kind of looks like a bayonet thrust, doesn't it? Now when I go back, you'll notice that I spin it out. Some people call that fishing. Some people call that just circling back. I do that so that if you're all tricky and think you're gonna grab the tip of this and disarm me, you still might, but it's gonna be a little bit harder. As I swing it back, noticing I'm loading for a thrust coming forward. Pretty simple, is it not? Notice my feet came forward as I did that as well. So you can start from a 50-50, almost a side stance, and step forward and thrust. Circle back, step forward and thrust. Bring it forward to rifle grip, neutral position. That's enough for now.